In this decade, we will complete 75 years of our independence. In this decade, we all have to work together with a new energy to give impetus to the making of a new India. With the efforts of my government, a strong foundation has been laid in the past 5 years to make this decade India's decade and this century India's century. Whether it is Pujya Bapuji's dream of Grama Swaraj, Baba Saheb Ambedkar's principle of social justice, Jawaharlal Nehruji's dream of creating a modern India, Sardar Patel's reserve for Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat, Deendal Upadhyay's goal of Antyodaya, Ram Manohar Lohiaji's vision of social equality, we the people of India will together make these dreams a reality. I am happy that in the last 7 months, Parliament has set new standards in inducting its business. The performance during the first session of this Lok Sabha has set a new record the last 7 decades. Due to my government's strong commitment, the law against triple talaq, ensuring justice to Muslim women and safeguarding their rights, the Consumer Protection Act, providing new rights to the citizens, banning of unregulated deposit schemes act for protecting the savings of the poor, the Chit Funds Amendment Act, protecting the poor from fraudulent chit fund schemes, the law enhancing punishment for sexual offences against the children, Motor Vehicles Amendment Act aimed at reducing road accidents, and the law protecting the rights of transgender persons, several such historic legislations have been enacted by the Parliament. I congratulate every member of the Parliament for fulfilling this constitutional responsibility. In a democracy, nothing is more shared, sacred than the mandate given by the people. People of the country have given this mandate to my government for making of a new India. A new India which takes pride in the glory of our ancient culture and which enriches the 21st century world with the power of its knowledge. A new India in which, besides finding solutions to old problems, new chapters of development are written. A new India in which adequate facilities and new opportunities for growth are available for the poor, Dalits, women, youth, tribals and minorities. A new India where every region develops, no region is left behind, where the benefits of modern technology reach the furthest end of the society. A new India, which is at the forefront of the fourth industrial revolution and which attains new heights at the global stage. Honorable members, for making such a new India, for fulfilling the expectations of the people, my government is working with commendable pace and decisiveness to bring about changes in every field. It is the outcome of reforms at the grassroots level ushered in by the government in the last 5 years that there has been an unprecedented improvement in India's global ranking in several areas. Rapid development of Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh, preservation of their culture and traditions, transparent and honest administration, and democratic empowerment are among the priorities of my government. During the president rule and since becoming a union territory, all the developmental projects in Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh have gained momentum. Towards the end of year 2018, elections, more than 4,400 panchayats of Jammu, Kashmir were conducted in a peaceful manner. For the first time since independence, elections to more than 300 block development councils have also been held there. The people there are now getting full benefits under Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, Ujjwala Yojana, Ayushman Yojana, Ujjal Yojana, direct benefit transfer and food subsidy in a transparent manner. Under the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, while around 3,500 houses were built in Jammu Kashmir till March 2018, in less than 2 years thereafter, the construction of more than 24,000 houses have been completed. Honorable members, the great saint of poet of India, Sri Thiruvalluvar, has said, Uduvar Ulagatarku Ani Ahud Atradu Yuduvarai Yellamu Purut. This is what the great saint Thiruvalluvar has said, that is like a linchpin of an axle. A farmer holds together the entire world. He bears the burden of those people who cannot cultivate the land. Our country is indebted to our farmers, who are our annadatas, because of whose hard work we are self-reliant in food grain, bringing about a change in the lives of the farmers who serve the country selflessly, and development of rural areas are the priorities of my government. The government is going to spend an amount of 25 lakh crores in the coming years to strengthen the rural economy. Government is working on a strategy to develop an income-centric system aimed at doubling income of farmers. Honorable members, today more than 121 crore people in the country have Aadhaar cards, and about 60 crore people possess RuPay cards. A record value of rupees 2 lakh crores have been transacted through UPI in December 2019. Recently, the government has also launched a new version of the BHIM app. The government has linked about 450 schemes to direct benefit transfer or DBT by using the JAM, Janadhana Aadhaar Mobile Trinity. An amount of over rupees 9 lakh crores have been directly transferred to the bank accounts of the beneficiaries through the DBT during the last 5 years. By plugging the leakages, my government has saved about 1,70,000 crore from going into the wrong hands. Honorable members, the objective of India's space program has always been service to humanity. Due to tireless work of country's space scientists, Chandrayaan 2 has stimulated a new interest in technology among country's youth. My government have already approved Chandrayaan 3. ISRO is also working expeditiously on the manned spacecraft program Gaganayaan as well as Aditya 1 mission. This decade, which has just begun, will determine India's global standing in the times to come. And it is the burden of every member of this House and every countryman to strive hard with all their capability to achieve their respective goals. We should all strive to make every citizen conscious of and dedicated to his duties in the national interest, and ensure that this sense of responsibility becomes the guiding principle of our civic life. Come, let us together make this decade of 2020 the decade of fulfilling our duties. We must always remember that we are first and foremost citizens of this country, and leaders are supporters of a particular ideology thereafter. The prestige of our country should be more important than our party loyalties. It is my belief that in the times to come, all of us together, drawing inspiration from the glorious past of our country, will make every possible effort to ensure a bright future for the country, and that we will also succeed in our endeavor. Let us all come together to fulfill the dreams of New India. Let us together make a New India. Jai Hind, Nandri, Vanakkam.